Okay, hello again, ladies and gentlemen. You are in the zone with me and your host, Isaiah. Yes, that didn't make much sense, but anyways, yes, this will be an interesting commentary of Black Desert Online. This will be my first time playing it. And actually, I took some time to configure some things, which you've seen right now. And, And I was using my controller, like a PS4 controller. And it worked very nice. It was strange, but it was really nice. And you see me now just whacking and swinging in the air, just testing out the whole aspects of it. So, that's how this goes. You can pretty much tell I'm a noob at this because I'm just searching around, clicking up some things. And again, I was experimenting too as the game went on. I'm pressing this, I'm pressing that, see what works, see what didn't work, and configure here, configure there. Yada yada yada, you get the whole gist. Will this cow stop looking at me? Really? Really? Or is that a steer? No, it's a cow. It's a cow. Okay, anyways. So, going back to what I said before, yes, I'm playing as a warrior class. Because I'm taking a knee. Okay, I'm not. Okay, anyways. I was playing the warrior class and see how it goes. And so far, I actually liked it a lot. The only thing I don't like about it is, well, let's be honest, it's the story. It's pretty much a rough draft from a Korean, like it's based in Korea. Well, the game itself, not the story, but you get the whole what I'm trying to get here. But anyways, the story didn't make much sense, but then again, to be fair, I was pretty much clicking it trying to get to the game. And so far, I like it. Not the story, I'm talking about the gameplay. And so, I think I get some time getting used to the story or get more time like playing it as time goes on, because I really do like this type of MMO where it's like it's not really turn-based, it's actually like open free like Warframe and some other MMOs I played in the past. For an example, I did like Marvel's Heroes 2016 or 2015, it's 16 or 15, either or, it was an awesome upgrade from the predecessor of last, well, a couple years ago. But anyways, oh no, I'm just dragging this on. It's on and on, on and on and on. Anyways, so again, I'm just messing around, messing with the controls, and it was really weird too. My attack button, if I use my PS4 controller for my PC, is that I use the square button. That's my. There you go. That's that green kit. Anyways. I use the square as my main attack, and left trigger, if I'm correct, or bumper, is my second attack. My circle is my other's hotkeys attacks. Again, I was basing this off of the, I can't talk today. I was basing this off of a memory I was playing from this game, which wasn't that long ago, which was today, and I was doing a lot of things beforehand, so. Sorry if I actually forgot. Okay, now I'm just asking people around. And I actually like that too. You're actually talking to an NPC and no one's getting your way of vision. So that was kind of cool. And, This is me checking my inventory, my settings, and you can see what I'm getting to the controller base soon. Yeah, I should say that beforehand that I was trying to find the right settings for controls. And also turning down the resolutions, so make sure the game can go by faster and smoother. And when I put it on high settings, it still runs at a nice 60 frames per second. So that was really cool. So I always liked that too. That was always a nice bonus. Yeah, so you can pretty much tell I'm gonna talk my way throughout this whole video because there is a lot of annoying sound within this game, like an audio loop. And trust me when I say this. It's much better to hear my voice mumbling and trembling and stepping over words and whatever than hearing that one of the god-awful background sounds. Again, it's like a kid yelling, scratching on a chalkboard at the same time. Yes. Yes, I know. Anyways, I'm looking at my other notification bar down here. I know, you can't see my face, so that's a good thing. Because me, again, I was just pretty much yammering away. Anyways, also, there was something I didn't like as well, is that there's so much icons on your display, it was kind of hard for me to focus. But I got used to it as time went on. Again, it's my first time playing it. Like, okay. But playing with a controller, it feels very smooth. It's very nice. You gotta get the attacks down and also memorize what attacks can do what again, and also do this and do that. It's really a pain in the ass too. I wish it had like a D-pad map out, like a visual map out, instead of just saying like you have words. They got multiple wordings and things like that. Yes, I'm a visual person, not a imaginary person. Yeah, that's a mouthful. Anyways, going from this video. Again, this is me just doing a lot of odds and ends. I'm just repeating myself again. So after this video is going to be the next one, because I had to stop it multiple times because I was trying to get the right feeling, and plus it was dragging way too long than it needed to be. So we're going to go to it very shortly, as long as I stop messing with the menu bar. Yes, this took me about... And that was the one thing I didn't like about the tutorials too, which I do not like the tutorial in any game really, but Black Desert tutorial was very annoying. I know they're trying to get you all set up in a other Kit-Kat Kaboodle, but it was like in your face annoying. Not like how Warframe is, they tell you like brief moments and then do it as you play it, or they show it on screen. Not like in your face, but like as the game environment. This was not part of the game environment, it's pretty much part of your face. Like the whole UI and everything else, like ugh. So that's why you see me like a long pause, because I'm trying to figure out the gamepad's configurations, and also I have my keyboard with me as well. And you're gonna act like, why can't you use keyboard, Isaiah? Well, I don't like keyboard. Okay, keyboard and mouse is not my thing. I've been playing console since forever, and now we're going to the next video, and it's still dark. What was I thinking again while doing this video? I have no idea. Yeah. Okay, now we just skip that part. Thank God. Alright, so... So that was really cool, though. And this is where my talking comes in real place. Is that this is where you hear a lot of annoying background sound. So I'll let you hear it for a brief second.
Isn't this just an excuse to drink more?
Leave Olvia to the vigilantes. We all have a strong attachment to this town. We should be the ones to defend our own land.
Okay, that was pretty much annoyingly silent of my voice. And again, like I said before, this is just me doing odds and ends, just messing around with controls and see how it flows. And it wasn't confusing. It was actually really fun to learn new things within Black Desert. It's kind of confusing why I call it Black Desert. I think there's an inside joke in that, but I don't know. But then again, I'm not that funny, so moving on from that department. Again, this is just me doing more odds and ends. What am I doing, Isaiah? I have no idea. Ha. What am I doing again? Oh yeah, this is me just looking at the movesets of my character. Again, I switched from keyboard to the gamepad, and the game, for some odd reason, doesn't know that, or there was no other tutorials showing you the gamepad version. Again, it's just me saying this because, again, my preference is a gamepad, not a keyboard and all other nonsense. Again, if Warframe can do it, they can do it too. I know I'm putting so much stacks on, comparing it to Warframe, which I'm not. I'm just saying it's just an experience I had. Yep, and this was an interesting development for me. Again, this is me still using my my PS4 controller. Again, I wasn't reading for that moment. Like, oh, what was doing that? Oh, okay. Again, I was using gamepad. Okay, you kind of get the point where I'm saying this multiple times that I used the gamepad, right? Alright, good. Stupid, shut up. That was my controller again. I have hooked it to a USB. cord, and somehow it goes wonky. Again, this is the price of dealing with Alienware. I know. It doesn't wig out on me on my PS4, because it's the same USB cord I use for my PS4. Because again, it's not that far away from me. It's a long cord, but you get the point. But you do anyway, so whatever. So this is me just again testing out the control. Left, right, B, blah blah blah. Again, this was actually kind of cool again. They totally combined some other movements together, which I did like a lot. So, bravo on them. I was like, they made this very unique, where I can just experiment, use different combinations and spells. But I'm not a wizard or a sorceress, by all means. I don't want to be none of those copycats. What I mean by copycats is that there's a lot of players playing as sorcerers, a wizard, or any magical type character, or a ranger, or whatever, or a ninja, or a berserker, or whatever. And I was okay being a warrior, because, you know, I'm one of the rare people you can find in the gaming world from Black Desert. And, again, I just kept liking it. I kept playing it because I was loving the gameplay. The gameplay was actually, it was, again, new, fresh, in a sense of a way. And it was fast. Just like Warframe. Like, I like kind of fast MMOs, so just like Warframe, that it doesn't bog you down over some large BS. Well, this did it anyways. But again, when you get on the road of fighting monsters and doing quests and all that other nonsense, it becomes a breeze to actually go through some quest missions, and you might see some other players too. And this is what I like the most, is where you help out another player. I don't like the whole player versus player, because I think it's because it's just me that I don't like fighting other players, because that's kind of boring. To me, it's kind of boring. I don't like multiplayer that much. There's not a lot of teamwork. But then again, you got a lot of morons online. Case in point, Grand Theft Auto Online. Pain in the ass. Anyways, back to what I was saying from before. And also, the only reason why I'm doing this commentary as well is because the sounds in the background, like, say, again, my controller that you just heard this a brief moment ago, and the background noise within the game itself, which is purely god-awful. And there was a lot of times where I just stood still. That's like I'm doing right now, because I was trying to find the gamepad version of, like, I'm getting this stupid blob creature. Again, I wasn't paying no attention. I'll be honest, I was not paying no attention. That's my fault. I kind of blame Neverwinter Nights for that, because Neverwinter Nights on a PS4 is godforsakenly boring. Yes, I didn't play much into it. I mean, I still got on PS4, but compared to Warframe, it doesn't feel like I should invest that much money. I mean, not money, but time. I mean, in Warframe, you can buy, but it doesn't give you that insistence that you must buy, you know? And Neverwinter, it gives you that sense that you have to keep buying X, Y, and Z with real money just to get ahead in life. I was like, oh dear God, not this BS. And this is what Let It Die as well. And again, you can find Let It Die again on PS4. It's an MMO free-to-play game. And it's like Dark Souls. And I said, okay, it's like Dark Souls. And it wasn't like brutally crunching as Dark Souls or Bloodborne. Then again, Bloodborne, I won't say it's extremely hard. I say it's challenging. You gotta be good at timing and patience. Timing and patience. Let It Die then was nothing like Dark Souls or like Bloodborne, where it's time and patience and also blocking, move. No, it's pretty much like if you have weapons, you're pretty much gonna die faster, because there's been multiple times where I faced off against players or whoever, and on the PlayStation Network, and they were all dicks, by the way. They were all trying to attack me, like, leave me alone, I'm not trying to attack you, I'm just trying to help you out. And they was trying to kill me. Truth be told, I have more aces up my sleeve. Like, I had a lot of reserve money, or whatever case may be, in-game money, to bring you back from the lock, bring you back from death, and kill them. And because they rely on their weapons so much, and I don't, I rely on my fists because they don't break or get tired. well, sorry, the body itself. And my character's already maxed out in stats, so they can't really fuck with me that much. It was like, oh, what are you gonna do with it? Like, they ain't gonna do nothing. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm talking about another game, but I should be talking about Black Desert. Again, why is it called Black Desert? I have no idea. And also, I'm the only black person up in this game, too. I mean by, like, NPC and me. Yeah, I was trying to be funny. I was trying to use a race joke. Yep, and that failed. Anyways, if I'm correct, I think I was going to do a lot of resolution type of testing. I think after a couple more bites, I had to change it because it was some moments that it froze on me. Or pretty much had like a little stutter. Not like in a bad way, but it seemed like my PC couldn't handle it. I know my PC can handle it, but if I want like a perfection of my game experience, I have to put everything on low. Depending on the situation. Again, I was trying to be stubborn, like, I don't want to do that, I want to look at like cheap pixels. No, again, this game still looks beautiful. It's hard to tell for my, the video capture I got. Video, oh my god. My recording, not video capturing. But it's the same difference. Anyways, I'm losing train of thought. Anyways, yes, for my recording from the NVIDIA Shadowplay, it might not look good. It might look choppy, maybe. It depends on the situation itself. But anyways, this is me just again. I didn't know I had to go to certain quests because I think it didn't really spell out that much, and plus, you can see on the right side of the screen, I didn't know it was completely done. Because on the map, it showed me my destination I should go to. But the thing about it is that I wasn't fully aware that I had to press X, Y, and Z to see how it was done. Again, this is just me fighting some weasels. And I'm gonna take a seat. Yep. Okay, this is just me doing things, and I like how the sword sparks off the ground. That was really cool. And also I had to readjust my camera and my movement speed to like 50%, because I thought it was too sensitive or not right. It didn't feel right. So I think at the end of the video, or close to the end of it, I made the right choice of changing my my mouse to be my looking and my movement as well. So my controller will mimic a mouse. Because again, my PS4 is more. It's like a mouse itself, a big honking mouse with buttons. It's always nice to have an MMO that can be configured to a gamepad. So I was really, really, really grateful that they put that in the game. And you know, going from there, like I can keep playing this. Again, I was just experimenting, see how it goes. Again, a noob who plays Black Desert and fails. But that's okay though. That is okay. Again, I was collecting shit and killing some monsters. Again, testing out the whole aspects of it, and also didn't know how to press X, Y, and Z to say I was done with this mission. See, you just saw there, it was a stutter, brief stutter. Again, the hitbox is not bad either. I think I was at the wrong like, angle or wrong spot to hit him, so I had to get a little bit closer. See, they're blending with the grass, so it's kind of annoying. But overall, I still had fun. Alright, this is me. And I also, one thing I did like about this game as well is that they have an auto run or walk. I forget what they call it. But it's where your character runs or walks to the destination you're supposed to go to without you doing like manually. You can do it manually, but the game itself helps you a little bit more better, or pretty much helps you navigate the world. It helps you get to one place to another while making it like stressful or just a chore. So this was really nice though. I like how the presence and bonds is actually stuck. And also, I was playing how you pick up things with the gamepad is also thumbstick, right thumbstick. Left thumbstick. We got like 20 more minutes to go. Yay. Again, I'm just pretty much killing some dead air here. Yeah, I didn't know. There were so many options I didn't know or pretty much wasn't paying attention. And again, I had to learn the hard way, and also I like to learn the hard way at times. It's like, oh, okay, that makes sense now. Kinda, maybe. How long is this? Hold on, let me see. Okay, I got like two more clips to go. Okay, cool. We got two more clips to go, and now I can stop this video. So save us all the trouble. It was kind of cool. That was kind of cool when I could kick the living crap out of people, and that might stun them or. It can aggravate it. Either way, I could care less. It's like, I'm still gonna kick you. Ba-boom! Like Weasel Stomping Day. Oh wow, that was that robot chicken joke. Yeah, that was really funny. Al Yankovic, yes. Cheesy, funny song. Robot chicken sketches. Weasel Stomping Day. Weasel Stomping Day. Yes, I can't sing. Yes, we're going with that already. Anyways. Like, see, I'm getting the hang of it now a little bit. Here and there. But again, it's still that damn display. You can see on the left and right. It was just the top and bottom. The top, I can be okay with. The bottom, just with my hotkeys. But, damn, all that other stuff I didn't care for. I mean, it was a lot of stuff I did not care for at all. Oh, here we go, this crap. Also, I was kind of shocked too that this map would actually show your enemies on the map, like before you actually get to them. So that was kind of cool. And also, it was like, oh my goodness, what was that? Puzzle books that you had like a special glasses that you had to put on, find which one was sticking out, like say which one was Waldo or whatever the case may be. That was really cool how they did it with their map. So I like it a lot. Again, there's not really big complaints I have towards this game. I really like it a lot. And I might do some more video recordings of me either failing or actually doing well. And this was I was being stupid. You can see on the right corner, this is where I had to put in all my my skills. Again, I didn't know that. Yes, ha 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 me. I wasn't paying attention. because there was so much shit on screen, it's like, okay, what am I gonna do with this? Going back and forth on how to navigate throughout the whole blah, because the gamepad itself is not quite right in a sense where, for example, Marvel's Heroes 2016 and Wolverine have a dedicated gamepad and it doesn't, you don't get lost in what you're supposed to do with X, Y, and Z. Here, there's still some more work to be done with the gamepad where the game will know that you're using a gamepad instead of a mouse and keyboard. Because there were several times I had to go to my keyboard and do X, Y, and Z. But again, that's not really big. It needs to be worked on the developer side or integrating some stuff. Either or, it's not a, nothing in the world. That was cool. Stay down. Also, which was also cool too, the mouse at times, when I had this screen right here, like mission complete or accepted the request, I could use the left arrow to move the mouse and cursor. So that was really cool. And for whenever I ever need the mouse cursor again, I just press my share button, which brings up my quest and also the cursor as well. So that was cool. What was I doing in that tree? This was, I was being stupid again. Oh, it's the herbs. That's some good herbs. Again, I'm trying to be funny but failing at the same time. Yes, you were coming. A blackest guy around. No, seriously. How do you not see a black guy coming through your neighborhood? Like, it's so easy. Like, oh, there's a black guy. Should we do something about it? Not yet. Yeah, I see that box there at the top. I'm like, oh, the box? I was making sure he was there. Again, the AI is not that bright. I'm not talking about it. I was going to bash his button. You got this button! Stay down on the button. Get wrecked. Break yourself, there we go. Yes, I used to remember. I'm still judging if I should really do more commentary on the last part is, what the hell was that? That wasn't important. That was some gobbly gobbly that I was not paying attention to. Helping our friend against the enemies in our game. So I did like that a lot. I like when games do that. Just look at the components and also bring this gibbity-gobble back. Gibbity-gobble. I don't know where it is. I just call it fairy. But I didn't call it fairy. That's what it's called. But you get the point. I'm trying to be funny for God's sakes. I'm failing. And you should not be watching this video. I'm being honest. You should be watching this video. This is so boring and sad. I'm trying to be funny, which I'm not. Oh, this right here was really cool. The knowledge base. It was where you will have knowledge on animal or monster, really, characters or team base characters or factions or the history or lore within Black Desert. That was something I liked, and I'd never seen that before in a MMO before, in a sense. Where they had like the lore mapped out, but you have to find it yourself to understand what this lore actually means. So that was really cool. I'll have to give him bravo on that one too, because this game does a lot of things right, and some games, I mean, in some parts a little bit wrong, but again, it's a work in progress for me. So again, I like this a lot more than others, and it's not up there at Warframe perfection, but it's getting there. It's like, and I keep playing it. Because Marvel's Heroes 2015 wasn't close until 2016 came about. 2016 with that big update, it was pretty much perfect to play with a controller, or play with friends, and so on and so forth. So, the Black Desert has that potential, I mean, a lot of potential for me to get to that high rank where I can play with controller with no issues and so on and so forth. You know, I gotta say so on and so forth because I don't play as hard as much. You can see why. Because I just mess around with my inventory still, what some things do, because the text is kind of small, and I got mixed up in my gameplay, maybe, if I think about it, or I just done some CPU later. Or both. Lay down on the ground. Break yourself, son. I do, because the combat is really fast. He was got learning new steps and anger. And I have to block this game because since I'm a warrior, I have a shield. Good luck, you think you're not seeing me coming up? Get out of the way! Boom! Yeah, Captain, you got me a big. Boom! Get out of the way! I'm doing this in the steps as you can stick over my fist. That'll be interesting. Anywho. Thank you.
Thalanos, Western Gateway. The node here can be connected from Western Guard Camp.
Aren't scary. I'm the most courageous goblin in all of Balanos.
Where is he?
A cave. The imp cave.
The search party?
On standby.
So it's in the northeast. You will go with him.
Yes.
If there's two imp leaders, this won't be easy. I'm Captain Cliff, commander of the Western Guard Camp. Grand Chamberlain Jordine can't be trusted. Everyone's following this old captain. I will protect them with my life. It seems that an imp named Red Nose is making trouble around here. Dangerous ones around. If you want to learn more combat skills, see Armstrong.
Thank you.
eat this garbage?
Princess, this isn't Heidel, you know.
I don't want to hear it. Let's just finish here and go home.
I knew this would happen. So you don't want to get paid, huh? This place truly is the middle of nowhere. It really doesn't suit me. I just want to get this done and return to the castle. Sir Jordine said he would come for me soon. He did. I knew this would happen. So you don't want to get paid, huh? This place truly is the middle of nowhere. It really doesn't suit me. Think you're going to scrounge a bit of gold following me around? I'm sick of Cliff's nagging. I don't want to hear it anymore.
Are you here to meet Captain Cliff?
Chamberlain Jordine can't be trusted.